brothers and sisters, good afternoon. Thank you all for being here. I am honored to speak before you. As you heard, my name is Father Gabriel Naddaf. I was born in the city of Nazareth, in the north of Israel, the town where the angel Gabriel, whose name I have, appeared to Mary, the mother of God, the very town in which Jesus Christ grew up and began his ministry. I was born in 1973, the year of the last major Israeli-Arab war. I grew up in what you know as the conflict. Nazareth is an Israeli city of Christians and Muslims. I grew up not knowing many Jews. As a child, the Arabs told me that we did not have good relations with the Jews and that it was our land, not theirs. They told me that the Jews were dangerous, and I believed them. But after high school, I went to live with my grandmother in Haifa, an Israeli city of Jews and Arabs. I began to work and meet with the Jews. Every day, I was around Jews. I worked in a Jewish hotel and was successful. And they sent me to training courses. They invested in me. I saw that the idea that I needed to be scared of Jews or that there was something dangerous about them was simply not true. The myth was exposed. Shortly after high school, I began my studies with the Greek Orthodox Church here in Jerusalem. My parents did not want me to be a priest. They wanted me to be a doctor or lawyer. My mom said I was too handsome to be a priest. And I said, what? Only ugly men can be priests. So I began to learn. I learned that we as a people, our roots are from the Jewish people. I learned that Jesus Christ was Jewish, part of the people that Moses led out of Egypt with the hand of God. Joseph and Mary, who raised Jesus Christ, were Jewish and knew the scriptures. Our prayers are the Psalms of King David and the words of the Bible, including the five books of Moses and the books of the Hebrew prophets. I learned that Jesus spoke Aramaic, the language of the Jewish Talmud. I understand that Christianity is bound to the Hebrew Bible, the Tanakh, and cannot be separated from it. This is something that the Arabs never told me. I wanted to learn more. So I asked myself, what is different about a Jewish life in the Holy Land and a Christian one? Do we not all share the same rights? The same freedoms? The same democracy? We do. So what is so bad about the Jews? They give me what no other Middle Eastern country will give me. Freedom, equality, and security. However, as I speak to you now, others are not so lucky. Across the Middle East, Christians are persecuted and murdered every day. In the past 10 years, 1 million Christians have been murdered in the Middle East and Africa. This means that every 5 minutes, a Christian is killed because of his faith. A faith that stands for love and peace in the world. A century ago, Christians were 20% of the Middle East. Today, that figure is estimated to be around 4%. Since the year 2000, over 77% of Iraq's 700,000 Christians have fled. In Syria, where there were 2 million Christians, there are now less than 250,000. Those who remain exist as second-class citizens. They face discrimination, physical threats, and have been subjected to the worst of crimes, rape, execution, and forced convergence. Why? Why? Because they believe in a different faith, a faith with a universal message of love and peace for all. This does not happen in Israel. Israel is the only place in the Middle East where the Christian community is growing. In the 1970s, the Israeli Christian community was about 56,000 in number. Today, we are more than 160,000, mostly Arab-speaking. The polls show that we are the most educated community in Israel. There are many Christian doctors, lawyers, and professors that work in Israel. So I ask you, if Israel is the only country in the Middle East where the Christian community is growing, and Israeli government is the only government that has ever given us full rights and freedoms, if Israel is the only country in the Middle East where Christians can speak for or against the government because we live in a democracy, how can you call Israel an apartheid state? I believe it is because people simply do not know the truth. People do not know that 20% of Israelis are not Jews. They are Muslims, Christians, Druze, Cherkessim, Bedouin, Baha'im, or one of many other communities in Israel. People do not know that in Israel you can work for an Arab just like you can work for a Jew. People do not know that there are Israelis of many colors. But even more, I think, what people do not know is the difference between Israeli Arabs and Palestinians. What people do not know is that the Israeli-Palestinian conflict is a conflict of nationality not race or religion. People do not know that when Palestinian terrorists attacked Israel, they are attacking me as well. Not only the Jews, not only the Bedouins and the Druze, they are a threat to all of us. People do not know that the Israeli defense forces are made up of all races, ethnic groups, and religions. My son, Jubran, an Arabic-speaking Christian, is in the army now. His commander is Jewish, and his commander's commander is a Muslim Bedouin. Does this sound like apartheid to you? In a country where Arabs can send Jews to jail for crimes, where Arabs can represent their communities in parliaments, where my son could be a military officer over an inter-division of Jews, I ask you, is this apartheid? No, it is not. I am Israeli and proud to be one. That means that I am a Zionist. Israel gives me and others so much freedom, rights. It is my home. And I will stand with my Israel. And I will stand with my Israeli brothers and protect it. However, even wonderful places are not perfect. Israel and all of us Israelis still have work to do. We are still working on living with our differences. We are still working on making ourselves and our country a better place. We are a young country, but we are strong, and we will overcome our challenges. We are still learning. Dear brothers and sisters, this is the Holy Land. This is Jerusalem. This is Israel, the Holy Land, the land of God. This is not Islamic place or Arabic state. This is not political message. This is biblical message. So I welcome you to listen, to learn, and to get to know my country, Israel. Thank you very much. God bless you all from Israel.